again, everyone. It's a bit fresh out here, but it's time to begin the repairs to the motorhome following the advisories on the MOT. Now, I'm going to start with the worn lower ball joint on the offside there. I've ordered a new one from Coastal Motorhomes and it arrived yesterday. So we should be able to press ahead and get that on. And while we're doing that, we can measure up for the new brake discs because there's two different sizes, 263mm and 290mm. And it's quite difficult to determine which one you have without actually taking the wheel off and measuring. Now, it's important to point out that I'm not a trained mechanic, so this is not intended as an instructional video, but more for entertainment and you following me as a vlog while I try and keep the van on the road. That being said, it may help you if you're considering this sort of job to see what I come up against. If you're in any doubt at all, consult a trained and qualified mechanic. Okay, well, you can see we have the van partially supported on the jack, but we're not relying on the jack. We've got an axle stand under there as well. And of course, you want to make sure you've got the axle stand on something pretty substantial. And here we've got it on one of the main chassis rails, so that should be nice and solid. We've also, of course, got the handbrake on and the back wheels chocked for a bit of extra safety. And you can see now why the MOT man wasn't too fond of our discs. This centre section here is really quite pitted. No way that's going to polish out just with the brake pads. It's probably as bad on the back. We'll show you the back when we get them off in due course. So while we're here, we may as well measure these brake discs to make sure we get the right ones and we order the new ones. Well, it's a bit of a crude way of measuring, folks, but I would say we want the 263mm discs. We definitely don't want the 290 ones. Well, that's good. That means I can go ahead and order those when I go back in the house. Now, the next thing I'm going to do is give the nuts and bolts I'm going to have to take off a good old soaking in plus gas. So I believe we're going to have to take these pegs off because we're going to want to retain them for the new brake disc. Now, this here that you're looking at, I hope you can see, is the old ball joint. And definitely going to have to undo that nut at the bottom and these four nuts here. So I'll give these a good soaking. Now, I think we could probably replace it at a push without taking anything else off, but since we've got to replace the brake disc anyway, it'll make our life easier if we take the caliper and the disc off before trying to do the ball joint. Now, there are some vehicles where you have to properly go to town. I've seen people have to take drive shafts off and loosen the anti-roll bar, all sorts of things like that. I don't believe we're going to have to go to those lengths with our Citroen C25 here, but we'll see as the job goes along. Anyhow, let's get some plus gas and squirt on those bolts we're going to have to undo. Before I go crazy undoing stuff, I don't want this caliper to hang down loose, so I've got myself a bungee strap. I've just hung it around the coil spring that I can support that caliper on if and when I get it off. Well, there are 22mm nuts on the back of this caliper. I wonder how difficult it's going to be to undo them. That one wasn't too bad. Sometimes it's easier just to nip them up, just a touch. Ah, of course, it's never going to be that easy, is it? Well, the top one wasn't too bad. Let's give it a bit more of a soak. Good thing is I'm not worried about contaminating the brake disc with oil, because I'm going to replace them. There she goes. Good tip is if you're doing something like this, always put like a kneeling mat or something under there, so if it suddenly goes, your hand doesn't mash into the concrete. Should also probably be wearing gloves for this. I've got some in the garage, I should be wearing them. I am a naughty boy. I'll go and get them in a minute. We got a ratchet on there now. Make life easier. I tell you what, let's go and get some gloves. Oh, the caliper is stuck onto the brake disc. Probably because of this lip, isn't it? You could raise this out a little bit. Try undoing these pegs and we might be able to remove the disc and the caliper as one and sort it out with it off the van. Yeah, so we better not lose this. This is a little packing shim that was between the caliper and the mount there, so we'll remember that. So I'm going to use these clamps to try and open this caliper up a bit. Well, I'll tell you what, it's 20 to 5 now, and it's getting quite dark out here, so I'm going to call it a night for tonight. We'll carry on with this tomorrow. Yeah, it's also just started to drizzle a little bit in the air, so definitely the right time to pack away, and it's not as if we're in desperate need of the vehicle, so no need to work in the dark and the wet, really. Well, it's about a week later, it's the following weekend from the first half of this video.
I got a bit frustrated trying to take that caliper off the disc, trying all sorts of tools to lever it off and stuff. Probably best when it gets a bit like that to take a step back and have a think. Should be able to just compress the two sides of the caliper and then it'll open up in the middle and pull it off the discs. Maybe those speed clamps I was using just weren't quite the right thing. Might try with some G clamps when I can get some more discs. But unfortunately, I ordered some discs. I had a look online and found various places that listed the discs. But when I went to buy them, they were all showing as out of stock. So I found a website that had a .co.uk address and I ordered from there some discs and some brake pads. But unfortunately, the following up, the sort of follow-up emails that I got made it clear that they were coming from Germany and they haven't arrived yet. Don't know if they got caught up in this palaver over VAT that seems to be going on at the moment with international shipments. So anyway, I think the thing to do is not to worry about separating the caliper from the disc at the moment. I don't think that's going to be an insurmountable problem. We should be able to do that relatively easy, possibly just with a G clamp, just to open up the discs a bit. I was trying those speed clamps and they didn't seem to quite work. Or if I really do have trouble, there is quite a lip on that disc where the sort of rust and corrosion is. And I could just grind off a section of that, the angle grinder, and then slide it out like that. But I don't want to do that until I know I've got new discs to put in. So I'll just move that all out of the way and we'll try and do the ball joint and then put everything back, drop it back on the ground so we can drive it around and put it on the front and stuff if we want to. Won't be driving it any distance on the road at the moment because of the lockdown. And then obviously wait for the discs and the pads to turn up. So let's crack on and see if we can get that ball joint done. Right, let's get this disc off and cable tied up out the way. We could also use a bucket perhaps to stand it on. See if that works. Right, so the next thing I'm going to do is give it another soak in plus gas. Hopefully it's been soaking all week. I haven't actually got round to reapplying any, but yeah. And then I'm going to try and undo this bottom nut there. So that's a 24 mil. Socket. And now I'm going to attempt to separate the ball joint with this ball joint fork. And for this job, I'm using a fork in the tune of E flat. So it's a pretty simple idea. You just use it to welt in between the old ball joint and the suspension arm. But it probably will tend to muller the rubber a bit on the old joint. So you want to make sure you've got yourself a new one before you do that. A hammer, perhaps. And there we go, that's nice and free now. So, about time to see if we can undo these nuts.
these are a 17mm nut. Probably need a ring spanner to get on these back ones because you won't get a socket in. And of course now it's started raining a bit. Now it's rather a tricky business to get your ring spanner on these. Yeah, the issue is that the rubbery thing is in the way. Maybe I could get a socket on it if I really try. No, that's not really working for me, is it? That's done it, I think. Splendid. And the other side. Right, now let's move those bolts out completely. Nothing nicer than laying in a puddle working on your van in the middle of January. Now, of course, it's a matter of getting this lower suspension arm down far enough to clear the end of the rod, and we might be able to do that perhaps with a jack. We could perhaps start disconnecting the sway bar here, but yeah, maybe that would be the easiest thing to do. Should we try that? I don't think it's necessary from what I've read. Other people don't seem to have done it, so possibly we can lever that down far enough to pop it out. Well, I'll tell you what, I'm going to use this nail bar to lever the suspension arm down, and then I should be able to pop out this ball joint. Now, I don't think this is really the safest way of doing it. I think probably a better way would be to undo that roll bar, but everything looks pretty corroded up. Now, if you're gonna follow my example here, I'd suggest you don't, but just be very aware of where all your fingers are in case anything slips. And there we go, it's out. Now, it's always worth having a look online before you do a job like this, because I've been looking on the Talbot Owners Club forum, and several people have said that these parts, if you use the new bolts that come with them, they're a little bit too long, and they can, when they go through, they can interfere with the CV joint rubber inside the hub. And yeah, if you look at these, that new bolt is significantly longer than the old bolt, so I shall be reusing the old bolts so I don't have that problem. So stick that back in there and forget about that. So yeah, this new ball joint, I really can't move that with my hand at all, but the old one,
Yeah, she flops around pretty good. So I guess the MOT garage were right, and that is rather warm. So excellent. From side by side, you can see they are pretty much identical. So the next job is to just clean up the seat under there where it goes, just so that's nice and clean, and try and get this new one in position. Now again, if you're going to do it like that, be very careful, don't get your fingers trapped. On each one, and they're not cross-threaded or anything. Can't be as rough putting the new one on, because you don't want to damage the rubber on it. I couldn't find any torque settings for these four bolts anywhere, but it's not a great idea to have them loose, that's for sure. Not the sort of thing you want coming undone when you're on your way to your holidays, so just good and tight, I reckon. This bottom nut, on the other hand, I have found a torque setting of 44 foot-pounds. On the internet. It's just in a forum post. Haven't found a sort of official setting, but that seems about right. So we're going to get the torque wrench and make sure that that's at the correct setting. The stud is just turning inside the ball joint, so we probably need to hold that. I suspect that's got an Allen key or something on the back of it, has it? No, I don't think it has. Maybe we just need to bang this on hard enough so it gets a grip on the taper. Yeah, that's done the trick. Yep, that's your 44 foot-pounds. Well, that's pretty much the ball joint replaced. Now I'm going to put the brake disc and caliper back on as they are, because those bits still haven't arrived. And yeah, we'll have to do the brake disc another day, I'm afraid. Noticed I didn't get the torque wrench out to do the wheel nuts again, and that's because pretty soon they'll be coming straight back off. I did do them up nice and tight, and I'm sure it'll be perfectly sufficient to move the van on and off the drive and back round to the garage and stuff like that. It won't be going on the road until I finished the job and torqued those wheel nuts down. Now I'm glad that I took the caliper and the disc off to do that little job. I think unless you had the vehicle up on a lift or on some ramps or something, well obviously not on ramps because the wheel was off, but unless you could get good access to the underneath of it, I think it is definitely easier to take the disc and the caliper off to change that bottom joint. But yeah, fingers crossed the other parts come soon.
Well, that's all for now. If you enjoyed it, press like, subscribe if you want to see some more, and ring the bell to be notified when we upload something new.